Hello, this is Pastor Dwayne, Pastor Jamie here on site in Sandy Creek, part of Leland, North Carolina, on property that we call Zebulun. And we just wanted to show you the sign that you'll be looking at as you're driving up and down I-74. And this is the site where our second ministry complex is going to be.
Amen. The Lord has told us this word. In Hebrew, it's Mahanaim. Mahanaim means two camps. Two armies. And that's what the call of this ministry is to raise up last days men and women of God,
yes.
Girls and boys of God,
yes.
To raise them up for this last days. We're building a campus in Hyco, West Virginia, and one here, right here. Hallelujah. And this land has been given to the ministry to do this,
yes.
Right here in Leland, North Carolina, just 13 minutes from Wilmington, North Carolina.
Yeah.
And we are already on WWAY on Sunday mornings, and we've been on TV for a little bit here now. And so please join us on Sunday mornings as that word is coming out to you and feeding you. And if the Lord is calling you to be a part of this mission, you know in your heart that God is raising you up to be a warrior for this time. This ministry is for you. We are being sent here for you. So check out the ministry website, see what we're about, see what we teach, listen to the TV programs, listen to some podcasts, start getting that word in your heart and start growing in from faith to faith and glory to glory with us.
Yes, and we can't wait to meet you.
And this is what the sign looks like now.
Yeah.
It will be changing soon, but this is how you know this is the land that the Lord gave us, right here on I-74 outside of Wilmington, North Carolina.
Yes.
We love you.
Hallelujah.
We welcome you to Getting Ready with Jamie Cart Ministries.
A threshold in a brand new year. Don't you want to know what God's plan is for this year? Tune in to Getting Ready. Come on, let's find out.
Let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house has many rooms. Who's he built all these rooms for? For the bride. Hallelujah. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. That is exactly what's getting ready to happen. And this is in the time of the camels and the bride. Glory to God. So, in Genesis 24, 31 through 32, this is a very long chapter. It says, and he said, come in, thou blessed of the Lord. So, this is a character that's introduced to us, Rebekah's brother. Rebekah's brother's name is Laban. We hear about Laban later on in the word, don't we? Laban got what on his mind? Money. Right? He's looking at all this. He's looking at the camels. He's looking at all the gifts and the wealth that has showed up at his door now. But it's attached to his sister. And he said, come in, thou blessed of the Lord. So can't you hear him saying, come in here, blessed of the Lord, man. Come on in here. Wherefore standest thou without? He's saying, why do you keep standing out there? Come on in. For I have prepared the house and room for the camels. Now, why are you going to prepare for the camels? Because it was time. Make room for the camels. That's the Holy Ghost. Make room in your heart, in your faith, in your receiving for the camels to bring you the wealth of the Lord, the wealth of the Holy Spirit, Eleazar. Make room for your camels this year. And the man came into the house and he ungirded his camels and gave straw and provender for the camels, and water to wash his feet and the men's feet that were with him. So he had servants with him. And so again, not only will the camels come to you that we need to make room for, the Lord's even going to provide for the means for these camels to come to you. Now, these camels may show up in an envelope. Your camel may show up with a knock at the door. Hallelujah. Your camel may show up with a phone call. Meet me at the bank. Meet me at the car dealership. Mm-hmm. Meet me at Lowe's. Your camel may show up with a big Lowe's thing, a Mack huge truck that has all the supplies you need. What's your camel going to look like? What do you have room in your faith of your camel to bring you this year? Amen. You are the bride. Start receiving your camels by faith. Hallelujah. What will your camel, your camels, have on them? Have supplies, have carpet, have drywall, have wood, have all the things that you could imagine for not just one building, for two.
Right.
What does your camel have on it? The answered prayers that you've invested in for 20 years. Could your camel have on it that someone hands you the keys and say, God told me to give it to you? You're like, I don't need another house. Well, but you do. Oh, yeah, you do. Because you're gonna house missionaries. You're going to do great things with these extra houses. Whatever God tells you to do. Could your camel show up with a breakthrough in your finances where the bank calls you and say, I don't know what's happened, Mr. Smith, but I know you said you owed us $50,000, but it's not in our computers anymore. And you just say, there's my camel.
Amen.
Whatever your need, what does your camel look like this year? That healing, that thing you've been believing for, and when it arrives, you're like, that's my camel. That loved one you have prayed and targeted and prayed for, and that camel arrives this year. But see, there's something attached to your camel, and it's your mouth. What are you going to say? What are you going to correct? What are you going to do with your mouth and your camel year? I am going to pull some things in. I am going to strive for speak the word only. God, help us all to speak the word only. What's that mean? You don't speak if you can't talk about God and the word and the truth and the light and the love and the goodness of God.
Right.
Can mean a lot of quiet times in your life. Amen. But that's okay. That's okay. Amen. Go to Genesis 24, we're in there. Let's go to verses 55 and 56. Excuse me. 55 and 56. And it says, now I'm reading in the NLT, so it may sound just a little bit different from your translation. 55 and 56 says, but we want Rebecca to stay with us. So, you know, Eliezer's there. He's made the proposal on behalf of Abraham. He's, of course, they see all of this wealth, everything. And so they're discussing, this is that part of the ketubah going on. But we want Rebekah to stay with us at least 10 days. So the family is saying to him, okay, we're in this. We see. Oh, yeah. But we want her to stay with us at least 10 days before this happens. Her brother and mother said, then she can go. So now the mother is involved with this transaction. Of course she is. But they want more time with her. They want to hold up something that God's doing. Ooh, because see, your family can try to do that. Your camels have arrived, and they're like, wait, you don't want to do that. What are you doing that for? That does not make sense to do that. But when your camels arrive, it's all, get on your camels and do whatever God's telling you to do. Amen? Yeah, but they right there were trying to pull on that situation and change it for them, for their own good. So again, but we want Rebecca to stay with us at least 10 days. Her brother and her mother said, then she can go. 56 says, but he said, don't delay me. This is Eleazar. The Lord has made my mission successful. Now send me back so I can return to my master. So he is saying, don't try to change this mission. Don't try to change this mission. But look what happens in the next verse. And they said, we will call the damsel and inquire at her mouth. We are in the time of the mouth, pay, Gimmel the camel, and of the bride. And whatever the bride's mouth says is what's going to happen in this situation and in your situation. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. So in Genesis, we're skipping on a few things here, and she leaves. She uses her mouth and she speaks what she's going to do against her family. She's leaving home the next day. She's leaving everything she knows. She's leaving her bedroom. She's leaving her family. She's leaving her clothes. She's leaving everything. She may take some clothes. But I'm just saying, she's leaving everything. Everything in her life. She is laying it down for this mission of Eleazar, the Holy Spirit, coming to her, bringing her camels, and she says yes to it. Amen. And she leaves. She just leaves. Amen. Because when your camels arrive, it will require you to participate into what they brought you and to where they're going to take your life. It's part of your destiny. Glory to God. So at her mouth, pay, it's done. So in verses 63 through 64, so her bridegroom, here's what he's doing when he is a part of, when father sends out the camels. And Isaac went out to meditate in the field. What's he doing out there? He's praying. He's seeking God. That's part of the camel transactions that's going to happen in your life. So when we say, Lord, help us to get to the place of speak the word only, and I said there'd be some quiet, some, that's okay. It's time for you to meditate. Meditate on what? On what God's doing in your life. Meditate on what your camels are doing. Meditate on where they're at and what you're believing them to bring to you. What things, that those heavy burdens that we need them to carry for us. And Isaac went out to meditate in the field at the eventide, and he lifted up his eyes. And the Bible says when you lift up your eyes to the hills, that's where your help comes from. And saw, and behold, the camels were coming. When he was out there praying, seeking God, he saw the camels coming. Amen. He saw the camels coming. And then Rebecca lifted up her eyes, to which her help comes from. And when she saw Isaac, she lighted off the camel. That's King James saying she removed herself from the camel. And the Lord wants you to know tonight that these words saw and behold, the camels were coming. This is the word to begin this year. See and watch, the camels were coming. Hallelujah. Your camels Hallelujah. Are coming.
Hallelujah.
In this year, your camels are coming.
Hallelujah.
They're on the way as we speak.
Yeah.
Yet your participation of your mouth pay of 5783, your camels have to your mouths to move.
Oh, hallelujah.
They got to have your mouths to move.
Yeah.
They want to move. Yeah. They were created to move. They were born to move and to carry and to bring and to ship things to you and bring things to you and hold things to you. But they need your mouth to move.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
They need your mouths to move. This picture is a picture of this year. Your camels are coming.
Wow.
Your mouths will make them move to you. And they're carrying amazing things.
Yes.
More than you could even hope or imagine. More than you've even thought of yet. Way beyond anything you've even asked for yet. But they need your mouths to get to you, Bride of Christ. And the Holy Spirit, your personal Eleazar, your servant, your counselor, your teacher, He wants you to know that tonight. He wants you to know that tonight. That your camels are coming.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Praise.
Let's stand to our feet.
Praise
the Lord. If you receive this word tonight, say, I receive
this
word from the Lord. And
I
command
this seed
of the word
to
begin working in my heart.
And
I fully expect
a
grand harvest. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's put our hands together and give Him praise for that. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We put this prayer and petition with thanksgiving to you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Our camels are coming. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We receive. We command you, camels. Come now. Come quickly. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If we can have some altar time to begin. Just if you have a need, what a great time to bring your need to the Lord. If it's a healing, if it is a breakthrough in your family, if it's a breakthrough in your body, if it's a breakthrough in your finances, in your thinking. I've had to have that need breakthroughs in my thinking before. I don't know if anybody else has. Just been in a series of thinking things I shouldn't have been like, and wake up one day and think, what have I been doing? We all get to these places in our lives. And sometimes we don't even realize that we've been on this wheel like a hamster doing this in our lives and not really even knew that we had arrived at this place that we needed to change. So if everybody close your eyes. We're going to right now just settle some things in our lives. This is the best thing that we can do with the time that we're in. And that is leaving and exiting and entering and beginning a new year. Leaving this time of Tav 22 and entering into the Hebraic of 5783. The time of the mouth, the time of the camel, the time of the bride coming all together in one big picture. And Lord, we just right now, we come before you, Lord, as time is moving forward. And Lord, we thank you for everything that you've done this year that we're in. And God, now we are looking out and we're looking forward to this new year. Just like Isaac raised his head up and looked up, he saw the camels. God, we by faith and in our hearts and in our spirits, we are seeing the camels arrive now to us, being escorted by Eleazar, the God of the helper Holy Spirit. And Lord, we set the dial of our spirit man to go forward in this year, to go forward with God, to get more serious about you, Holy Spirit, than we've ever been. To learn and to receive the giftings of you, Holy Spirit, and God, to receive what you have planned for us that's more than we can imagine on our camels of this year. Lord, you know when I saw that this year meant camels, I giggled. Hallelujah. Because I thought, Lord, what's that all about? And now, Lord, I see and I'm still learning as you are taking and unveiling even more that, God, this is an important year of receiving, an important year of the bride making her surrender commitment to you, Holy Spirit, Eleazar, surrendering anything I need to in my life, anything we need to as the bride, and leaving what's behind and moving forward in this time of the mouth and the camels that will move us closer to our bridegroom. Just like Rebecca had to be moved closer and to arrive to her bridegroom, so will we in this year. That God, that we will not lose sight of what you can transport in the desert and have arrived right in front of us. Lord, we thank you for this time that we're in. We thank you, God, for this new year. We thank you, God, for all that you have stored up and it's being loaded on the camels as we speak. We thank you for these things, Lord, that you will have arrived to us as surprises throughout this entire year. Not surprising us because we didn't believe you for it, but Lord, you love to surprise your people with good things. And Lord, we thank you for these things. We thank you for the things, God, that we've been believing for a very long time, arriving this year. And we believe by faith for it, and we align our mouths up to do so. For those who need to make a new commitment or make a commitment for the first time to Jesus, to make him the Lord of their life or to return to him and make him the Lord of their life. Lord, what that means, the word Lord, is you're the master. You're in charge. And there's so many people that have made you their Savior, but not made you their Lord. And tonight is the night to make you the Lord of our lives. The Lord of our days and our years. The Lord of our mouths. In Jesus' name. So right now, if you've never received him, or you need to just recommit your relationship to him and make him the Lord in charge of your life, I'm going to ask everyone in the room, and we're praying for you right now from the mountains of West Virginia, those of you watching online and television, as the ones in the rooms may be making a recommitment as we're going into a new year. We're going to be praying with you, and they're going to repeat this prayer, and your job is to mean it with all your heart and confess it with your mouth. So join us in doing that. And just say and mean it. And say, Jesus, I come to you right now with my life. I surrender to you. I believe that you rose from the dead and took my place and I take your life, and you take mine. I make you the Lord of my life. Please fill me with the Holy Spirit and fire. Please forgive me of all my sins. I'm making a brand new start right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We're so happy that you have prayed that prayer. Please let us know here at the ministry. We want to celebrate with you. We want to send you some free stuff. If you need a Bible, we'll send you a Bible, and everything is free because the people here love you. The partners of this ministry love you, and that's why these things take place, is to love on you. Praise the Lord. Now, those of you who are in the room, those of you who are still watching online, one of the greatest things that you can do by ending a year and beginning a year is to begin that new year in prayer. I'm going to ask that the music in just a moment be brought up, and that you can go out on the porches. It's still kind of warm because it's not raining here in West Virginia. Use spending time, if it's on your couch, if it's in your bed, wherever you're at, if you're in a jail cell, wherever you're at, in a hospital bed, is that you begin this new year with Jesus, and that you begin this new year believing Him and His Word, and that you believe that all things are possible with God. Amen. And then the second thing is that if you need to repent for your mouth, of your attitudes, of your tones, if you've been grumbling and complaining, whatever it is, get your mouth in order so that your camels can get to you quickly. You don't want it to be all just at one time of the year. Hey, I want many camels encounters this year, don't you? I don't want just one or two camels. I want the whole entourage to happen, and I want it to go over and over and over again. Why is that? Because I want to be a distribution center for the Lord. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. So we're going to turn up the music. Go spend some time with Him and surrender anything you need to. This is the time to do this. Amen. We bless you. Those of you online, we bless you. Happy New Year. Go spend some time with the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Hello, everybody. This is Pastor Dwayne and Pastor Jamie from Hyco, West Virginia. We just want to say Happy New Year.
Yes, Happy New Year. We bless you in the name of Jesus from the mountains of West Virginia to Leland, Wilmington, North Carolina.
If I can encourage you this year, rejoice always, pray continually, and be thankful in all circumstances. We love you.
Amen.
Thank you so much for watching Getting Ready today. This ministry is called to reach the lost and to help the bride of Christ get ready for the wedding day, which is the rapture of the church. All this is made possible through the faithful prayer and financial support of our partners and friends. If you would like to become a part of the JCM family, please contact us. Also, send us your prayer needs and praise report. We would love to hear from you. Until next time, keep getting ready. Jesus is coming.